So welcome to the 24th tutorial of Python programming series. Now we are going to see expressions and type conversion. So what is an expression? You know in math we had f of x equals to ax square plus bx plus c, or any equation which is equal to some expression. So that is nothing but an expression actually. So f of x equals to ax square plus bx plus c is an expression. But when we write ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, then that is an equation because we equated the value of that expression to something. So that becomes an equation now. So expression is nothing but f of x equals to ax square plus bx plus c equals to, not equals to, just that much, plus c. So that's an expression. But in Python, suppose you want to know more, you can just write a equals to, say you wrote 10 plus 4. This is nothing but an expression now. There are actually many types of expressions. That is nothing but theory actually. You know many expressions in Python. When you read it, you will understand. So see, these are the constant expressions. Integral expressions means we just write a equals to 10. That is, 10 is a data type and we assigned or we linked a to it. So we just assigned it. So again, floating point. When we divide anything, we get floating point obviously. Then relational, we saw these as well. The logical expressions also we saw, bitwise and all. Bitwise also we saw actually. When we saw, we use logical expression in if conditions and all. We'll see that afterwards now. And again, assignment expressions, we saw these as well. So you all know these, but this is just a theory, so I want you all to just know it. And afterwards there is type conversion now. So this is a kind of important topic. So if I write a equals to, say I write 10, hold on, okay, I write 10 plus 4. Now what do you think should be the output? So when I print out a, I got the output as 104 because it did not add it. What it did is, see, I wrote 10 in double quotes and 4 as well in double quotes. So when I write anything in double quotes, it identifies it as a string. Python identifies it as a string inside double quotes. So Python knows that 10 is a string and 4 is a string. So when I write plus, it concatenates it. That is, it adds it basically. Not maths add, it just adds both the strings. Or you can say join. Join is a better word. Instead of add, it just joins two strings. So it concatenates them. So it just wrote 10 plus 4 means it just concatenated the string. So 104. And after that, say you want to add them. Or we can see one more example. So what if I write 10 plus 4 and run this program now? So it gave me an error. Why? Can concatenate only string, not integer. So what is the error is? So see, 10 is a string over here, but 4 is an integer. We didn't give any double quotes to it. So it cannot add or concatenate a string to an integer. So let us assume that 4 is a, actually instead of that, I'll just start it over. So suppose you want to add 10 and 4 now. So what to do if you want to add two strings? Add means, I mean, like we add in maths. So suppose I have a equals to 10, which is a string. And if I write b equals to 4, which is a string again. And I want to add 10 and 4. So just if I just write print a plus b, what I'll get is again the concatenation, that is 104. But if I want to add the strings or the integers, I'll just convert a into an integer and b into an integer again. So when I wrote this thing, int of a, it just means, int means integer and in parentheses means a. So I converted this string a into an integer. So the highlighted value that I did is nothing but 10. Normal 10, that is an integer and not a string. And this value is 4. Normal 4, that is an integer and it is not a string again. So it, and when it sees plus between two integers, Python adds them. So when I run this program now, I get the output, that is 14. Because it is an integer now, both these are integers, so it just normally adds them. So what we did is type conversion. We just converted strings into an integer. You can do the same thing for float values as well. So if I write float of a, and again if I write float of b over here, float is nothing but decimal points, you can say. So what happens over here is, float of a, that is float of string 10 is 10.0 or 10.0, and float of b is 4.0. So when we add 10.0 and 4.0, we get 14.0. So that's it. And after that, and you know, actually we can do one more thing. So suppose a is a floating value, that is a is 10.4. And now if I converted a into an integer, you can think what happens. I'll just run this code now. So when I converted 10.4 into an integer, what did it say? Invalid literal for int, because with base 10 actually. See, because this base is not 10. 10.4 is a floating value in a string, so it cannot be converted into an integer. You can try it for yourselves as well. So if I write a equals to 10, and afterwards if I write, or rather 10.4, and if I write print a, और इंटीजर वैल्यू ऑफ ए, आई डोंट नीड दिस थिंग नाउ, ओके. एंड व्हेन आई रन इट अगेन गिव मी द सेम एरर बिकॉज इट इज अ फ्लोटिंग वैल्यू एंड कैन नॉट बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू एन इंटीजर. बट वी कैन एक्चुअली सी, वी कैन नॉट कन्वर्ट फ्लोटिंग वैल्यू इनटू इंटीजर, बट वी कैन कन्वर्ट एन इंटीजर इनटू अ फ्लोटिंग वैल्यू बिकॉज एन इंटीजर इन फ्लोटिंग वैल्यू जस्ट मीन्स 10.0. सो दैट्स इट. And see, we'll see the type convergence now. So we saw these examples only. 10 plus 4 in strings just concatenates them, and we converted them into an integer, and then it adds them. So we can convert into an int, integer value, long value. Long is nothing but a long integer. You can see the meaning of long in decimal and all. We'll see that afterwards. So this is float value. We saw that string, tuple. We can convert it into everything. So ORD, octal and hexadecimal, we'll see these all things afterwards. You might not know these for now. CHR also you might know, unicar also you might not know. So we saw dictionary and all, you know these things. You can convert a tuple into a list, or you can convert a list into a tuple, you can do anything. So suppose I have L equals to a list. So I write L equals to say a list of any random numbers. And I want to convert this L into a set. So to convert it into a set, simply what I have to do is print set of L. And when I run this thing now, it gave me the set. And see, this is a good thing over here, because see, L is 34, L has 34 two times, but what does set do? Set does not have repetitive elements. It just removes the repetitiveness. So it removed the other duplicate 34 and it just gave the original elements. So that's all. These are the type conversions, and there's one more thing which is known as type casting and type coercion. Hold on, I'll just need the, yeah, this thing. So what we did over here is we have both the strings and we converted them into an integer explicitly. Explicitly nothing means externally. So we write externally as integer of a. So what did we do is we did type casting. So we just converted 10.4, actually it was 10 first. So when we did this, we just explicitly converted 10 and 4 into integer value. So actually this is type casting. And what is type coercion? C-O-E-R-C-I-O-N. So what we do over there is, so if we simply print out 10 plus 4.0. So this is a value, you might think actually because see, 10 is an integer, but 4.0 is a float value. And we run this program now. We got 14.0. We didn't get any error. Why this happens is because you might think because these are two different data types, so and we didn't explicitly convert them into a float value, so how did we get the output and all. But what did Python do is it automatically converted 10 into 10.0 because it sees this float value and it sees this plus, so it wants to add them. So to add them, it will have to convert 10 into a floating value. So that's why Python converted it. So we didn't did it externally or say explicitly. Python did it. So this is nothing but type coercion. So this is the main difference between type casting and type coercion. In type casting, we converted it into we converted any string value into a float value or a integer value explicitly. And in type coercion, what we did is, actually we didn't do anything. Python did it internally. So we don't know how it happened. It just happened. So I think that's all for this tutorial. We have many interesting videos in the next tutorial. I'll see you all. Thank you.